at 31, I had a question coming off of section 5.4, number 57. And this said to use a calculator with CAS. I'm not even sure what CAS stands for to answer the question. We don't need to do any of that. I'm just going to do this by hand because it says to, hey, can you take a look at this expression and think about what's happening with k equaling 1, 2, and 3. So what happens when we change this exponent here? And then try and predict what happens when k is equal to 4. So can we find a pattern as we work through these first three exponents and then try and extrapolate that to 4? So the first thing I did was, let me erase this. So the first thing I took a look at, I'll change pen colors too, is I said, okay, let's let k equal 1. So I'm going to change that exponent to 1. And that becomes just x over x plus 1. And now you could have used division for this if you wanted to. I probably would have used long division, and let me just do it off to the side here. So I would have taken, x plus 1, and I would have divided it into x. And then I would have said, well, what do I need to multiply x by to get to x? And really nothing. So I would just put the 1 here. And then this would become x plus 1. I would subtract these things. That would cancel by design. There's my remainder. So that's one way to get that fraction, or I should say that quotient. That's what you're seeing there. All right. Now, another way to do this, just for fun, because I see this trick later in math. So if you're not going to major in math, maybe forward to where I get to the k equals 2 case. So sometimes we do this. We like to add 0. So we say this numerator, I could rewrite this as x plus 1 minus 1, because really all I did was add 0. So 1 minus 1 is 0. I'm not changing the problem. But the thing is, what this allows me to do, let me change pen colors, is I could regroup this in that form. So what I could do is I could rewrite this as, why is this not coming through? There we go. X plus 1 minus 1 over x plus 1, right? Oh, that doesn't look centered. Let me center that thing just so you have it. And then I can split this up and make it x plus 1 over x plus 1 minus 1 over x plus 1. And x plus 1 over x plus 1, sure enough, it is 1. So there's just another way to do it. You don't have to. I just wanted to show it to you because I think it's kind of cool. And this whole adding 0 shenanigans does happen once you move on in math. Okay, so next up, we got to try k equaling 2. So now I'm going to make this power up here 2. All right, so let's go ahead and write that. I want to see what happens with x squared when I divide out x plus 1. So I decided to use synthetic division here because I had that lead coefficient of 1. So synthetic seems easier. So I put negative 1 here. And then my coefficients up top, right? Keep in mind, this is like saying x squared plus 0x plus 0. So that's why you see my coefficients of 1, 0, and then 0. And then with synthetic division, right, bring the number down. There's 1, 1 times negative 1, negative 1. Add these up, right? And here becomes my work from when I'm doing synthetic division. Well, okay, keep in mind that this quotient here, and let me rewrite this, right? We were doing x squared over x plus 1. I started with something squared. So that means this coefficient is going to have to do with a first degree term. So this is going to be x, right, from positive 1. And then I'm going to have minus 1 here. And then my remainder was 1 over x plus 1. All right, so just keeping in mind what we have. Here was the case when x was equal to 1. Here was the case when x was equal to 2. I personally wouldn't have seen a pattern yet, but I'm going to try this now with k equaling 3. So now let's go run this with k equaling 3. And let me move this up just a bit. Let me move that down. All right, so when k is equal to 3, I'm looking at x cubed over x plus 1. So again, it's still an opportunity to use synthetic division, keeping in mind my numerator is x cubed plus 0x squared plus 0x plus 0, which is why you see these coefficients here. All right, so if we use synthetic division, I bring the 1 down, right? Negative 1 times positive 1 is negative 1. I keep adding up and down. And here are all of my coefficients. Well, I started with something cubed, so I'm going to use this lead coefficient off of something squared. So as I look at this, I have the x cubed over x plus 1 is equal to, I've got positive x squared minus x plus 1 minus 1 over x plus 1. All right, so here is my third output. So if I kind of get all of this into view, things that I start to notice here, I'm going to change color. So I notice that the signs between 1 and negative 1 are altering. I see positive 1, negative 1, positive 1. Positive 1, negative 1, positive 1, negative 1. And even up here, if I had done synthetic division, you can see I had positive 1 for my lead coefficient and then negative 1. So I have a bunch of alternating 1s, and that can help me figure out what's going to happen when I go to the x equaling 4 case, or the fourth power. And if I look, right, I always have that positive lead coefficient. So when I go to do this, you see I have positive lead, or a lead coefficient of positive 1, negative 1, positive 1, negative 1, and then there's my remainder at positive 1. So that's just me extrapolating the pattern I see. I'm always starting with positive 1, and then I alternate between positive 1 and negative 1 as I play the rest of my quotient out. All right, so there's number 45. Thanks so much. See you later. Bye.